Hello, world. It's me again, Demetrius from Mitri J. I just wanted to come and talk to y'all about this thing that I heard about, that I read about today. It's about, the new winner of the annual Miss USA pageant. Her name is Rima Fakih. I'm not sure if I'm saying that correctly, but somebody tell me if I'm saying it wrong, because I don't know. But anyway, her name is Rima Fakih. Not only is she the very first Arab-American woman to participate in this Miss USA pageant that's been going on for the past 59 years, but she's the very first Arab American woman to actually win the whole shebang. So I think we should all congratulate her. Kudos to you, Rima. And also, I think we should congratulate, and give kudos to the Miss USA committee or whoever picks who wins, because I think that this shows that, we as a country are moving past this whole, prejudice or racism towards Arab Americans. I think it's great. Okay, enough of the sappy ish, because clearly I'm about to sign in on some of these people. I'm about to take some of these people to Chech, not church, Chech. Yes, you gotta make the face too. Chech, okay? And if you're watching this video right now, you just might not be a part of the target audience that I'm trying to get to, but listen up and listen tight anyway. And I hope you got your pen and pads, because I'm about to say this three times. One for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Ghost.
Please, it's good for your health. Stop hating.
Then you got all these people talking about, oh, she can't be Miss USA. She's anorexic. She's too skinny. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, clearly she's not anorexic, because right after she won, they asked her how she felt about winning, and she said, oh, ask me after I go get some pizza. Please tell me, people, how are you going to be anorexic eating pizza? I mean, come on. Do these people think? Seriously. Can we not even give her the benefit of the doubt? No, forget that. As my cousin would say, y'all not even giving her the boot of the duh. Let alone the benefit of the doubt. I mean, so what, you see a hip bone protruding from here or there? So what? Who cares? I mean, that's just her. I've seen the pictures. She's skinny, but she ain't that daggone skinny. She got some meat on her bones. So I advise y'all to calm down. Y'all know what? This whole situation is just plain downright ridiculous. Because, I'm gonna tell you what, half the people that are saying she's too skinny are probably aspiring anorexics and want to be as skinny as she is. And then there's the other half that's probably morbidly obese and are just jealous because they're not as skinny as she is. And the other half is probably people with low self-esteem that are just mad because they're not as pretty as her. And I know that's three halves, but people, please stop making excuses for yourselves, saying that you care about this or that person's health when you're poking fun at their physical appearance. Number one, you can't care for her because she could fall off the face of the earth right now and you wouldn't even know. You wouldn't give a flim flam. Number two, you could say, oh, I do care about their health because I have a big heart. Well, guess what?
Newsflash. People with big hearts don't poke fun.
I love America, but I'm really starting to think of my fellow Americans as those annoying, hypocritical family members, because, I really love y'all. But it's just that I don't know what to do with y'all, because y'all got my head spinning around and around. It just feels like we don't like fat people or we don't like skinny people. Y'all can't be doing that. Y'all can't be just flippity floppity. Like, y'all, we all as a country have to come together and come to a consensus or an agreement on one prejudice.
Just kidding.
No, but seriously, it's like 1 month you're getting on Gabourey Sidibe from Precious's case for being too daggone fat. Now you getting on Rima Fakih's case about being too daggone skinny. I mean, I just don't know what to think anymore. I'm so confused. Like, y'all got me feeling like Erykah Badu in Window Seat. Tell me what you want from me. Concluded. Like, I really think we should change our national anthem from the Star Spangled Banner to she's too big, she's too wide, she's too fat, she's too skinny, she's too short, she's too tall, she's too this, she's too that, she's too dark, she's too light. Like, that's what I really think. Okay, this video is getting way and, entirely out of hand, so I'm gonna have to cut it right there. But anyway, the moral of this video is to, love yourself, be who you are, and don't let anybody tell you anything different. Because my friend told me these words yesterday, and I forgot who wrote them, but they're very, very powerful. So here it goes. Be careful what you think, because your thoughts turn into words. Your words become your actions. Your actions turn into habits. Your habits become your character. And then your character becomes your destiny. Very, very powerful, right? See? How about those green Granny Smith apples? And please don't forget to subscribe. I'm trying to reach 100 before my birthday so I can celebrate in August, So if you would kindly please help me on that quest. And if you don't have an account, please make one. By all means, make one. It's not that hard. It just takes like 5 seconds. And subscribe to me, Demetrius, at MetriJ. And if you want to see more of me and my friend Naji, please subscribe to the NZ Experience. I'll put the links up at the end of the video, you know, all that good stuff. But y'all know how it go. So, love, peace, and a bottle of head green.